Hello everybody, welcome back to a new drawing. I know it's been a while that I talked to you guys and I'm really sorry, but I have to be honest, I didn't feel like doing every day a voiceover and I'm kind of shy and my parents were home and yeah, so I didn't record, but now I'm back and for a while at least I'm back. And Inktober is still going on, but this is a special drawing for Helloween. And also it's my first ever YouTube collab that I'm doing. And I'm so happy, I'm so glad. His username is Santos, and before I spell his name wrong, I will put a link to his YouTube channel in the description, and maybe if I can in the video itself. Check out his videos, he is an amazing artist, he is also on DeviantArt and on Instagram. I don't know if he's on Facebook, but it could be. Just take a look, I don't know. I follow him on DeviantArt, YouTube and Instagram. He is a great person, really nice to talk to, and he has amazing art, I really love his art. And I was so happy as he asked me if we could do a collab for Helloween. And I just felt like really, yes, someone wants to make a collab with me. I wanted to make some for a while now and I was kind of really, really happy that he asked me. And because of that, I have watched some videos that had two parts of it. Like someone did the upper part, I don't remember the name. Like the upper part is something like forest, and the down part is like a sea with fishes and everything. And I really like that idea, and I wanted to try this too. So, as he asked me and asked for like ideas, if I had some ideas, I told him this with the clown that has strings that go down to the upper to the lower part, I mean, and has the bodies of people attached to it, like using them and everything, and he really liked the idea. I was really happy because I would have listened to him with other ideas, but he thought it was really cool and he asked me to do a little sketch so he could understand it better what I mean with it. So I did a really, really rough sketch that I won't ever show to anybody else than him, probably. And yeah, he thought it was really cool, so we decided who would make a witch, and so I get the clown because I just really felt like doing a creepy clown that's come out of the dark and you only see his hands and his hair, face and this collar, something like that, that he has around his head. Not around his head, but I think you know what I mean. And I really wanted to try to draw a creepy clown. And I'm really sorry for everyone who has fear of clowns, don't like them at the moment because of all the news with the creepy clowns that attack people and everything. They're kind of stupid, but please don't hate this video and the video of my collab partner, because on the lower half he did the screens and the heads of the people, and a second clown that is the underling. Underling? Is it called like that? I don't know, I'm sorry if not. Is the one that is working for this clown that I'm drawing. And he does the unpretty things. So he's like chopping them off, cutting them, killing them, torturing them, and I don't wanna go on. because I kind of feel like, oh, this could be banned, but I hope not. It's a Helloween drawing, come on guys. Helloween has to be creepy and everything. And so I don't have the second part yet, but as soon as I will put them together in GIMP. So I will put them together digitally, and I hope I can fit them together so that we have two pieces in one. And I'm really excited to see them together because I only seen a VIP, so a work in progress of his drawing, and oh my gosh, this looks so amazing. I can't wait to see them both together. I have to admit, I'm kind of proud of my clown too, because it's my first clown and it's kind of the first time that I'm drawing something creepy. At least it's creepy for me and for the people that don't like clowns. So sorry again. And yeah, I really had fun drawing this because it was my first time, and this idea just stuck in my head, and I really wanted to draw a creepy clown. And yeah, what should I tell you, mom? So I started this as soon as I could, because I knew I wanted to do Inktober that I'm still doing, but this video will come on a few days, maybe Wednesday or Thursday before Helloween. And I knew that I would try to do Inktober, and happily I can say I'm still doing it. And so I started this really fast, or really before it kind of was like Helloween or October. And I sketched him, and then I did the sketch digitally, because you can change the look of it, like, I don't know how it's called, you can change the position, like, the right thumb is on the left and the left on the right, and I played a little with it because I didn't want to take that much paper anymore, like at my last drawing that you will see after Inktober. And so I fixed some mistakes and made it alright till I could transfer to a good paper, and made it a little more with details and everything. And after that I started inking, but you see on the beginning, I know it's a little bit far away from that what I'm telling you now, but I'm sorry, the info had to be done. And then I started coloring it. I used markers, colored pencils, and at the end that I sadly didn't record, I used some pastel colors. I hope I used the right term to it. I think it's pastels, that really soft, that you can smear with tissue or how it's called. And it did make the dark even more darker, and I really liked that effect. And with the hair, I tried something like just making little points so that his hair looks really fluffy and soft. And I did make the clown's clothing really like a clown, so really with yellow and red. At first I thought about doing another color, and one of his eyes where he has that green, I thought, should I do it in yellow too? But I thought that would be too much red, yellow. And I thought it kind of suits a clown if he has more colors. So I did that one thing in green. And yeah, I had to put the three drops that look like three little teardrops or something like that in the color of red, because it kind of looks like he's bleeding or he's crying red tears, and that I thought it would be cool. And yeah, I had just a blast doing this. As you will see soon, I put some blood splatters on him and his lips that will be red as soon as I get to it. I made them a little bit smudgy so that you don't know if the lipstick just smudged or if it's the blood from underneath. So I really had fun doing this, and I know I said that already, but I have to be honest, it was really, really something new, and that's why I like Inktober. I wanted Inktober to be something that puts me out of my comfort zone, because I mostly draw girls. At least I try to draw beautiful things, and I kind of never do animals and everything. And I just thought Inktober will be the month that I will try to make it out of my comfort zone, and I kind of did it, and I'm pretty proud of myself. And even before October and Inktober started, this is one of the pieces that got out of my comfort zone too, because I really don't remember that I ever did a creepy drawing ever, and I really like this. I like or loved horror movies, I even do now, but I don't like to watch them alone, and they have just something. I really like to watch them, and it kind of felt really funny to draw something that is more bloody, more creepy, and I'm wondering what everyone will say, because this is something really that I normally don't do, and I'm really proud of it because it is my first, and I think it's pretty okay. I'm sure if I would do more, it will be more better. Yeah, my English is perfect as every time, no? And yeah, it was really fun, and I have to admit, I kind of miss talking to you guys, even if I'm only talking to myself and you listen. But somehow this isn't even that bad. That the first time I did voiceovers, I felt so uncomfortable and everything, but slowly I'm getting into it, even if I had somehow like a month of hiatus or something like that, how it's called. And I'm sorry that I didn't do voiceovers for that long. I hope you will forgive me, and I hope nobody will cringe at, wow, this video is really long, but this did take so long time to color and everything, and I just wanted to show it all to you, and I just felt like, after that long time, it kind of feels good talking to you guys like that. So I hope you don't feel like, oh gosh, please shut up. And if you do, I'm sorry, but just put some music on. And I'm still thinking about what I will put under my voiceover, like music. I want something creepy so that the Helloween sound will come out great. I even thought about doing something like a witch that is laughing, but I still have to search something like that, or I would like to try it, but honestly, I don't want you guys to make a run, and so I won't laugh like a witch, but I kinda sound like one right now. I'm sorry. I'm not used to it anymore to talk so long in a row. Yeah, the video is pretty long, I know, and thanks for everyone that is still watching. As you can see, I started on the dark part, and even watching it, I'm so happy that I did this, and thank you, Santa Snob, again, for asking me to do this collab. I would love to do more with you, and I can't wait to see the drawings together. I'm sure it will be a blast looking at them, and it will look so good. I'm really happy to do this with you, and it will be amazing. As long as you can see, the strings don't really can be seen now because of the dark background. I can't talk anymore. I'm sorry, guys. But I will do this with a jelly roll pen so that they can be seen better. And I can't wait to hear what you guys say to this drawing and to the collab and his part. I can't wait to watch his part, to be honest, and to put them together. I'm all like, oh my gosh, I want that drawing and I want to put them together because I want to see how it looks. And it's just amazing. I really hope I could do more of collabs with amazing artists because there's so many out of there. And I felt so good to be asked, and I hope this will get a few likes. And it's the end of the video. Here you will see the finished one as soon as I have it. Thanks for watching, leave a like and subscribe for more. See you the next time. Bye bye and happy Helloween!